Hello everyone, this is Varsha. Welcome to Programming Knowledge. So in this tutorial, we will understand what are web elements, what are the different types of web elements, we will understand the locators and its types. Also, we will understand the difference between find elements and find element method. So let's get started. First thing, what is web element? Now, anything that is present on the web page is called as a web element. For example, the text boxes, the drop-down menu, the radio button, anything that is present on the web page is known as a web element. Let me show you this site. For example, this is the web page. Now, anything that is present on this web page, anything that is this search bar, these my account link, this more link, this cart link, the search icon, anything that is present over here is a web element. We have to inspect all these elements. Like over here, if you want to send any command, if you want to send any text message on this search bar, how are we going to do that? We're going to inspect the elements. So all these are known as web elements. Now web elements are basically of two types. One is single element, the second is the group elements. Now single element, this is the registration page. Here you can see these text boxes, right? So these are single elements. Why? Because of we can easily find out and locator to work with this. For example, we can find out through ID, we can find out through name. So these are the different types of locators that will be used to inspect these elements, these text boxes, this radio button. But I'm explaining here what are the different types of web elements. So there are two. One is the single element, the second is the group element. Single elements are the text boxes because we can identify them very easily through locators, through name, through class name. Whereas the drop-down menu, they are known as group elements because here to identify the drop-down menu, we will use a locator as well as that we will use a combination of a value or an index property. Now, what is this value or index property? When we understand how to inspect the drop-down menu, at that time we will come to know that what are the different types of commands that is used to inspect the drop-down menu. So that is the reason why it is called as a group element. So next we have locators. Now what are locators? Locators are the way to identify a web element. Anything that is present on a web page is called as a web element, right? So how do we identify it? For example, here you can see, right, this search box. How will you identify the search box? How will you send commands to the search box? How will you click on this icon, on the search icon? How will you do that? For that, you need to inspect these elements. For that, you need to locate these elements. So how are we going to do that? Simply just place your cursor on this element or whichever element you want to inspect. Just right click it and click on inspect. And here you can see I'm actually placing my mouse on this syntax of search button of this search box, and it is highlighting. Here you can see, right, it is highlighting. So this is the way you can inspect your web element, and through these locators we will inspect the element. For example, here you can see input. This input is your tag name. It is an element. Your input has many attributes, like we have class, we have type, we have name, we have title. So these are the different attributes of input tag. So we will be using these attributes as locators to locate these web elements, to inspect these web elements. Okay. So now what are locators? Locators are a way to identify a HTML element on a web page. As we just saw right now. Now there are different types of locators. One is a locator, the second is a customized locator. Under locator, we have the ID, we have the name, we have the link text and the partial link text, we have the tag name, we have the class name. Whereas in customized locators, we have the CSS selector and the XPath. Now this XPath is one of the most important locators, and it is frequently used by many automation testers because it is one of the most easiest thing. And we will be using a different plugin for this XPath that is called the CrowPath plugin. So choosing XPath as a locator will be one of the most easiest locator. Even though ID, name and all these are easiest, but most of the time automation testers, they prefer the XPath locator. Okay, so we will do that at the end because there are many technical things also in this. It is a little hard to understand. Before that, we will understand what is ID, name, link text, partial link text, tag name, class name, and CSS selector. And we will have a command on this. We will practically implement also this. Okay, so locating by ID. Now, before proceeding, I would recommend you to have a basic knowledge about HTML, which will be very beneficial for you because we are automating the web pages over here, and a web page is made up of HTML, CSS, JavaScript languages. So your HTML and CSS will play a lot of role over here in locating the web elements. Just a basic knowledge and then it's fine. Okay. So now, locating by ID. Now ID, they are unique for each element. The ID value that we have, right, is always unique for each element, and it is one of the most common way of locating an element. And the ID are supposed to be unique on a page, and that is the reason why ID are the most reliable locators, like in form of priorities. Whenever the automation tester tests the application, the first thing that they will do is they will try to automate the web element through ID. Because ID, the value of ID is always unique for each element. So that is the reason why ID is one of the most reliable locator, and they're fastest and the safest locators out of all the locators. Okay. Now let us assume this is your text box email address, and you want to send some value over here. You want to automate this field. Okay. You want to inspect this field. You want to send some value over here. How are you going to do that? And this is the HTML syntax that you have for this text box. So how will we locate this element by ID? We will simply write driver.findElement. Here I am using findElement and not findElements. Okay. Driver.findElement by .id. And here, when you inspect this element, when you right click and inspect on this element, here you will get the syntax right. Over here, ID is equal to email. You will place this value over here. Now see, whatever value you enter here is case sensitive. Okay. Whatever is written over here, you have to write it over here the same way. Like over here, the email is written in small letters. You need to enter your email in small letters only. It's case sensitive. Okay. Then I will send a form command. This is the send key command over here. This is a form control which is used over here to send a particular text to this field. What I'm doing is send keys abc@gmail.com, right? So I'm sending this email ID, that is abc@gmail.com, in this text field. The text field which is located over here, this email. So you get it. I'm writing driver.findElement by.id email, which I found it over here in the syntax, dot send keys abc@gmail.com. So this is the way how I'm going to locate the ID. See, we're going to implement it also. First, just understand this command. Okay. The next one, locating by name. The next locator is name. Okay. Now here, same thing. Just assume you have a text box, which is name, which is of email address. And this is the syntax of it. So how are we going to locate by name? Is the same as ID, but the only difference between name and ID is that name locator are not unique for a page. Like I said, for ID, for each element, the ID value is unique. Whereas for name, it's not that. Okay. That is the difference between the ID and the name. So over here, you can see, right, name is equal to from. Similarly, we will write driver.findElement by dot name from dot send keys abc@gmail.com. So this is the command which I will use to locate by name locator. Now let's implement this practically. I'll just open my IntelliJ IDEA IDE. So now I'll create a new Java class. Simply, I'm having this project named Selenium, and I'll create a new Java class. I'll name it as Selenium Tutorials. Now here you can see this web page. Now we will be automating this web page. So the task that we have for today is, here you can see this search bar. So we will be automating this search bar. So how are we going to do that? We're simply going to click on the search bar and click on inspect. And here you can see as my mouse is on the syntax and you can see that the search box is highlighted. Okay, here we have different attributes like the class, we have the type, we have ID, we have name. So we will be using these attributes to locate this search element one by one. Okay, so let's do it. Now open your IntelliJ IDEA IDE and create a new class. I created a new class in my Selenium project, that is the Selenium Tutorials 2. And in the previous tutorial, I explained how to launch a browser. We will be launching the Chrome browser. So here I have written the two commands that were used in launching the Chrome browser. That is the system.set property. Here we have to enter the key value, that is the webdriver.chrome.driver, and the path of the executable file, that is the Chrome driver executable file. Next, we had written that the webdriver driver is equal to new Chrome driver. So these two commands are used to launch the Chrome browser. So let's run this. Okay, so here our Chrome browser is launched. Now what I want to do is I want to maximize this Chrome browser. That is, my Chrome browser is minimized right now. This is what I want. So how am I going to do that? I'll simply write driver dot manage dot window dot maximize. So this command will maximize the Chrome browser. Now let's see. Let's run. So here you can see my Chrome browser got maximized. Okay. Then the next command. As I said, we are going to locate this search box through ID and by name. Okay, locators. So let's do it by ID first. Let's do it by ID locator. So first, okay, sorry. Just before that, we have to navigate to the URL, right? So first we will navigate to the URL. We're going to write driver.get. I'm going to enter this URL. And yeah. Okay. So yeah, first we launch the Chrome browser. We maximize the Chrome browser. Then we navigate it to the URL. Let's check it first. It's launched. The Chrome browser is launched, maximized. And it is navigated to this URL. So I'll just close this. Now, as I said, I want to locate this search box, through ID. Now here, same, I'll just place my command, click on inspect, and here this syntax here you can see, right? This syntax, here you can see ID is equal to search underscore query underscore top. So this value will be used to locate this search box. Now, how am I going to do that? Just check it out first. Okay. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to write driver dot find element. It's find element and not find elements. Okay. Find element. I'm going to write by dot. See here you can see it's by dot tag name, ID, class name, CSS selector. So I'm using ID. ID. And then I will here insert the value of ID that is given over here. Simply just double click on it, copy it and paste it over here. Okay, it is case sensitive, so paste the same thing. This value should be same as the ID that is given in that syntax. Okay, now what I want to do is I want to send some command to it. So I'll write send keys and I'll simply just type, I want to send t-shirts. Chrome browser is launched, is maximized, it is navigated to this page. And here you can see, it's here, it's written t-shirts, right? We haven't inspected this element, this search bar, and that's why it's not clicking on this, okay? We will do that later. So now, this is the first way of writing driver.findElementById.sendKeys, okay? The second method that you can write, this command is, let me comment this. So I can write driver, similarly, just the same thing, but I'll write it in a different way. Find element, I'll write by dot id okay, that's it. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to store this in a variable. I will name it as search is equal to driver dot find element by dot id. Now what I'm doing, I'm locating a web element, right? In Java, usually when we write it as int a is equal to 10, right? Then we write float b is equal to 10.2. So here you're giving some data type to your a and b variables, right? So here also we will, this search element. So here also we will write something, right? So what are you going to do that? So what are you going to write? Simply here you see this search underscore query underscore top. What is this? We are locating a web element, right? So we are finding a web element on a web page. So this search variable will be of what type? It will be of web element type. So web element search is equal to driver dot find element by dot id search underscore query underscore top. Okay. Now over here you could see I had written dot send key. So simply what I'll do is I'll write search dot send keys and I'm going to write t-shirts. Okay. So let's run this command. This is the second way of writing this one line command. You can write it this way or you can write it this way. Depends on your choice. Okay, so I'll just run this. My Chrome browser is launched. It's maximized. It is navigated to this URL. And here it is. Here you can see it's t-shirt. Here the value is sent. Okay, so I'll just close this. Close this also. Okay, so I'll just comment this. For now, this method is better. Okay, next we will do it by name. We will locate the search box by name. Okay, so how are we going to do that? Again, we're going to write driver dot find element by dot name and here you will see we have the value of name. Just double click it, copy it, paste it over here and write dot send keys. I'll write shorts. Okay. So now let's run this. Chrome browser is launched. It's maximized. It is navigated to this URL. And here you can see. Okay, wait a minute. Okay, I didn't comment this. Let me comment this. I'll do it again. So I'll click on run. The Chrome browser is launched. It's maximized. It's navigated to this URL. And here you can see it's shorts. Okay. So I'll just close this. Now we have understood how do we locate by ID and how do we locate by name. Similarly, here you can see the same way you can write it by name also. There's nothing different in it, but this is the most precise way. You just write it in one line. Here you have to write in two lines. It's the same thing. So I prefer this one. So it's up to you, which one do you prefer? There's no harm in writing either of the way. Okay. So we have learned by ID, we have learned by name. Next we have locating by link text and partial link text. Now what is link text and partial link text? See, whenever we have links in our pages, okay, like there's a web page and there are links involved in this. In that case, we have the link text and the partial link text. Now link text and partial link text both are different. They are not the same, but partial link text is not mostly used by the automation testers. Link text is mostly used by the testers because this is the most precise way of automating or clicking a link. For example, like suppose, let me show you here this page, you can see, right? Now here, woman, I have dresses. Now there are various dresses over here. So if I want to click on this link, here you can see this link. So if I want to click on this, like how am I going to do? I'm just simply going to click inspect. And here you can see this. You can see there is an anchor tag over here. So this anchor tag is used for links in HTML. Okay. Now here you can see, is there any class? Is there any name or ID attribute used over here? No, right? So how will you identify this element? How will you inspect this element? We will inspect this element through link text. That is the link text which is written over here. You can see woman A line multicolor dress. You can see this text written over here, right? We're going to inspect through this text. This is the link text that is given over here. And the A class, which denotes the anchor class, which is used for links in HTML. Okay. So for clicking the links in Selenium, we will be using the link text locator. So how are we going to locate this element through link text or partial link text? Now, for example, here we have various links like the printed dress, the printed summer dress, and this is the syntax of this. Okay. So it is a syntax of printed summer dress. So how are we going to click on this printed summer dress? How are we going to click on this link? For that, we will be using, I'll be explaining link text first. We'll write driver.findElement by.linkText. Printed summer dress. Here you can see this is printed summer dress. This link text is used to identify this element. Here you can see there is printed summer dress. This printed summer dress, right? This text is used to identify this element, that is the printed summer dress. Okay, so I'll just simply write printed summer dress. This is case sensitive, just write it the same way. And dot click. Again, before we were writing send keys, right? That is the form command. This is also a form command which is used to click a specific element or to click a specific link. So what operation I need to perform over here? I want to click this element, right? Printed summer dress. So I'm going to write dot click. Similarly, for partial link text, what you do, you partially write the text. Like over here, we have the printed summer dress. We'll just write summer dress. Still, it will detect this printed summer dress and it will click at this link. Okay. That's the partial link text and the link text. Now here, the partial link text means that we don't need to pass the complete value here. You just need to pass a portion of the text. Like I said, you need to pass the portion of the text. I have passed summer dress over here, right? So through this also, it will click at printed summer dress. So let's practically do it first. Just open your IntelliJ IDE. So I'll just create a different package over here. I'll just create a different class over here for link text and partial link text. So I'll just write Selenium Tutorials 3. Okay. Just click on dresses. Okay, so I'll just copy this and I'll paste this URL here. Okay, so now by link text. So it's going to be driver dot find element by dot link text. Okay. So now here I want to click on this link. So how am I going to do it? I am going to inspect this element first. So I've inspected this element. Here you can see I have the printed chiffon dress, which is written over here. This is the link text. I will copy this and I will paste it over here. And I'll simply write click. Okay. So now let's see. Okay, it's launched. It is maximized, it is navigated. And here it is selected. So here you can see this is printed chiffon dress. As I had written printed chiffon dress dot click, so here it's clicked. Okay. Now let's try it by partial link text. So I'll just simply command this. I'll do it by, what I'm going to do is I'm going to write driver dot find element by dot partial link text, and what I'm going to enter is chiffon dress, and I'll click this text. Okay, so now let's run this. Chrome browser is launched, it is maximized, it is navigating. Now it's clicked. Okay, so now you can see through partial link text also my printed chiffon dress, this dress, this link is clicked. So now we have understood ID, we have understood name, then we have understood the partial link text and the link text. So next is class name. Now through class also we can locate our web element. For example, we have this text box name, email address, and we have this syntax of HTML syntax. Now we have the attribute class over here. Here we have the class attribute form control, the value is it. So how are we going to locate by class? Simply just write driver dot find element by dot class form control send keys and whatever value you want to send away. It's similar to ID and name. There's no such difference in it. But this one thing is that the class name, that the value of form control, now this value can be of multiple elements on a web page. It's not unique. Whereas the ID is a unique value, right? Which is given to each element. For each element, the ID value is different. Whereas for class, the value for each element is similar. Like for multiple elements, there must be a class name form control. Okay. So in that case, many of them don't use class. The automation testers, they use class locator very less as compared to the ID and the name. So the next locator that we have is the tag name. Okay. Now tag name are used to find multiple elements on the web page. Like, let me tell you what is tag name. Like suppose here you can see, right? This input, this is your tag name. This is the tag name here over your input, and the attributes are this type, name, ID. These are the attributes that is used. So tag name are used to find multiple elements on the web page. For example, suppose this page, okay. Now I want to find the number of links present on this page. So how can I do that? I'll simply click on inspect. I'll find the anchor tags, the number of anchor tags present on this page. Okay. Through that, I can find out the number of links that is present in this page. Okay. So tag name. Now your tag name, like A, Like here, the A, the anchor tag, is used as a tag name. Now, through this A, that is the anchor tag, we can locate the, we can find the number of links present on this page. Now, remember, tag name is used when we want to find multiple things. Like suppose I can now, if I want to find the number of sliders over here, like how many sliders are present. So how am I going to do? I'm going to inspect the element. Like under every anchor tag, we have the image. Like suppose, for example, let me inspect this here. Yeah, you can see under every anchor tag, we have the image. So the source, image resource. So through this anchor tag, I can inspect the number of sliders that is there. I can inspect these sliders, how many sliders are present, how many through this image tag, I can identify how many images are present on this web pages. So the tag is used to find multiple elements on the web page. Now, for example, it is mostly used like if I want to find the number of sliders, if I want to find the number of links on this page, if I want to find the number of images on this page. So through this, I can find the number of multiple items or multiple elements on the web page. So let's implement that. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to, let's create a new class, Java class, right? Selenium tutorials. Okay, so I have created a new Java class over here. I'll write driver.get, and in this I'll write, let me inspect this element. Okay, we will inspect this. We will try to find the number of links present on this page. Okay, let's see whether this program runs properly or not. Okay, my Chrome browser is launched. Is maximize, it is navigated to google.com. okay, so now what I want to do is I want to find the number of links that is present on this page. Okay, there are many links like this image, Gmail, and there are links like Hindi and the different types of languages. So I want to know the number of links that is present on this page. So how am I going to do that? Okay, simply I'll use the tag name tags over here. So here we will be using by tag name the locator. So I'll just simply write driver dot find elements. I'll use find elements over here because I have to find multiple elements over here. Okay, by dot tag name, and here I'll write which tag do I need to inspect to find the number of links that is present on this page. So I'll be inspecting the anchor tags that is present on this page, right? The number of anchor tags, I want to know the number of anchor tags that is present on this page. So I'll be using A. This is the tag name which I want to inspect. Okay. Now here I have used elements, find elements, right? So what I'm going to do is I'm going to write a variable over here. Link is equal to driver.findElements by dot tag name. Now this link is of what type that we need to decide, right? So how are we going to do that? Now here, this find elements, okay? This find elements need to return a list. It needs to return a list of elements. It needs to return a list of web elements. Web elements are this A, this anchor tag, the links that is present on the web page. Anything that is present on the web page is known as web elements, right? So we are returning a list of web elements, right? We need a list of web elements. So here we will be using the collections concept that is there in the Java, in which we have the list. That is a Java util package. And here in list, this A tag is what? It is identifying what? It is identifying a web element, right? So I'll write a web element. So this find elements is designed to return back a list of web element, which is what is being assigned to the variable link. Okay, whose type is of what? List web element. Okay, so now here there's a variable link. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to write s out and link dot size. Now the size method is used to find the number of elements that is present. Okay, number of elements that is present on the web page. So this command through link dot size, this method is used to find the number of elements. Okay. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to save it and let's run. Chrome browser is launched. It's maximized. It's navigated. And here you will see there are total 27 links present on the web page. Now what I want is I want the name of these links. So how am I going to do that? To print those name, I'll use the for loop. I'm simply going to write for, and here we are inspecting the web element. So I'll write web element. I'll name it as L, and here I'll write link s out, and I will write L dot get text. Now the getText method is used to retrieve the or to return the text that is inspecting, that we are inspecting. Over here we are inspecting the links, right? So it will get the text of those links. That means I want the name of the links that is that they are identifying over here. These 27 links, right? I want the name of these 27 links. So I'm writing a for loop in which I have given a web element L because I'm inspecting a web element, that is the links I'm inspecting. I've stored it in L, and here I'm printing those links, the name of those links. Okay, so I'll just click. And here my Chrome browser is launched. It's maximized, it's navigated to google.com, and here you can see we have the different types of links that is present over here. Okay, so through this way we can find the number of links, and we can find the name of the links that is present. That is, we can find the, we learned the get text method and the size method over here. Okay, creating by CSS selector. Now the CSS selector, this is a type of customized locator. Now before studying the CSS selector, we need to study some CSS concept. So let's have a look at it. Now for example, we have a front page.html. We have this HTML file, we have the HTML tags and everything. And inside the body tag, we have this div tag, okay? Now we have written div class is equal to box. I have given the class value as box, okay? And then I have given the text and every, like I have given a code inside this div element, this div block, whatever it might be. But the thing was over here is about the class and the ID, the difference between the class and the ID over here, okay? So we have this front page.html in which we have the div tag. Inside the div tag, we have the class, okay? And the value of this class is box. So if I append the style sheet in this HTML page, so how will I style this class? How will I style this div block? So I'm going to style through this class value, that is box. Now how am I going to do that? To access this class, I'm going to write this dot. Do you see? I'll be accessing it through a dot. This is a period that is used while accessing the class value, okay? So I'll write dot box, and then whatever attributes I want to write, like color green, red, or whatever it is, whatever formatting I want to do, or whatever style I need to add, I'll add between these blocks of code. Okay, so this is one concept for class. We will use a dot. Now let's see for ID. Now here we have the front page.html similar, and we have the div block in which we have the div ID is equal to box one. I have given the ID value as box one. So if I want to style it, what I'm going to do, I'm going to use the hash symbol over here. Here you can see I'm using the hash symbol to access this ID. I'm going to use the hash symbol, that is the hash box one, and then whatever styling I want to perform, I'll perform between these blocks. But the thing that I want you to understand over here is that for class, we are using the dot, and for ID, we are using the hash. Okay, so this is the CSS concept you need to know for the CSS selector. Okay, so now locating by CSS selector, that is the tag and ID. Now just assume we have this text box, that is the email text box, and this is this HTML syntax that we are having. Now here for tag and ID, your tag, what is your tag name? Your tag name is this. This is your tag name input, okay? And these are your attributes like the class, ID, name. These are your attributes, right? So what you're going to do is, like for tag and ID, it is tag name hash ID. Like as I said in the previous slide, to access ID, we use the hash, right? So over here, we'll use tag name hash ID. So how we're going to write is like driver.findElement by dot CSS selector. We'll use CSS selector over here. We'll write tag name first. The tag name is input, so we'll write input. Then we'll write hash, hash. And then we are going to write the ID value because it's tag and ID. The CSS selector that we are using is tag and ID, right? So we're going to write the ID value, that is email. Okay, now this is case sensitive, just write it the same way which is it is written over here. So we're going to write input hash email dot send keys. Okay, whatever text you want to send, just send it over here. So this is how you're going to write the CSS selector for tag and ID. Now let's see for tag and class. Okay, so here we have the text box, email address, and we have the syntax over here. So how are we going to write for tag and class? For class, we use the dot operator. Here you can see we use a dot, right? So similarly, before we were using hash. Here you can see we were using hash for ID. So for here, we are using the dot for class. It's the same thing. We're just going to write driver.findElement by dot CSS selector. Input dot, that is a tag name. Your tag name is input dot. Class value, the value of your class is control, right? So I have written control over here. Dot send keys at the rate abc at the rate gmail.com. Whatever text you want to send over here. Okay, next we have the tag and attribute. Okay, so how are we going to work with tag and attribute is tag name. Then we have the attribute name is equal to attribute value. Now we can use any of the attribute that we want. Like over here, we can use the driver.findElement by.css selector. Input name, like here I can use ID, I can use name, I can use class, anything I can use. So I'm using name. Name is equal to from, that is the attribute name is name. My attribute value is from, here you can see, and my tag name is input. Okay, my next CSS locator is tag and class and attribute. So how am I going to do that? Simply, I just have this text box, that is the email address, and I have the syntax over here. So what I'm going to do is over here for tag name, it's tag and class and attribute, right? So for tag name, we'll first insert our tag name, that is the input. Then we have the class. We want to write the class. For that, we need to use the dot operator over here. We are using the dot over here, dot. The class value that we have is control over here. It's control. Then the attribute name. Now here I'm using ID. You can use any of the attribute. So I'm using ID is equal to email dot send keys abc at the rate gmail.com. Okay, so I hope it's clear for you. The CSS selector. Now see, CSS selector is not mostly used by the automation tester. They don't use this CSS selector a lot. Instead of CSS selector, they use the XPath. See, the frequently used locators are the ID, the name, and for links we use the link text and the XPath. The XPath is used frequently by all the automation testers because it is one of the most precise form to use the locator, and it's tough to understand, but once you understand it, it's very easy to use. Okay, because we have a CrowPath plugin to use that. We will use that plugin to find our XPath. Okay, so next, one of the most important interview questions that you will face is that what is difference between the find element and the find elements? Okay. Now, we found this find element and find elements in tag name. In tag name, I wrote a program in which I used find elements because I wanted to find the number of links on a web page, right? I wanted to find multiple web element on a web page. So that's the method used to find multiple element on a web page. We use the find elements. That's where I use find elements, right? So the first difference is that find element, this method is used to access a single web element on a web page. We will use to access single element on the web page. Till now we were accessing find element because we wanted to access only one web element, that is the text box or some other box, that is the email box. So we have to access only one web element. So that is the reason why we are using find element. Whereas in find elements, this method is used to access multiple web element on a web page. In our case, we were finding multiple anchor tags, the anchor tags, that is the A tag that is used on our web page. We were finding the number of links in our web page. Okay. Next, in find element, when the element is not found, it throws an exception. See, whenever the element is not found in find element, it will throw an exception such as no such element is found. Okay. Whereas in find elements, when the element is not found, it returns an empty list. It will return some empty list. Okay. Next, the find element, it will find only one web element. Whereas the find elements will find the list of elements which matches the same locator. Like if we have written A as a tag name written over here and we find the number of A tags. So it will return the list of elements. That is, the list of elements will be returned as I have shown in the program. Let me show you the program. Here it is. Here you can see it is returning the list of web elements. That is, it is returning the list of links. So the find elements, the find elements will find the list of elements which matches the locator. Now let me explain you when the element is not found. Like here you can see when the element is not found, it throws an exception, no such element found, right? So we're going to do that. I'll show that. I'll implement that for you. For example, suppose let's go to this tutorial and recommend this. Okay, and suppose this by name. Okay, I'm just writing search, just writing something so that you don't find the element. I'm using the find element method over here. See, what I'm trying to do is I'm trying to prove you this statement that when the element is not found, it will throw an exception, no such element found. I'm trying to prove this statement. Just check it out. Okay, so I have changed the value over here. Now let's see. The Chrome browser is launched. It is navigated. So let's see. See, here you can see no such element exception, no such element, unable to locate element. Here you can see we have got an error over here. Here you can see name is equal to search underscore QU. Unable to locate element. That's what I said, right? For find element, when you're using find element and the element is not found, you will get an exception that no such element found or unable to locate the element. Whereas in find elements, we will return an empty list. Now let's try to do this one. We use the find elements method here, right? Find elements. Now let me change the tag to, suppose I'm changing to AR. Okay, this is what the tag I'm changing, and I'll just comment this for time being. It's navigated. Here you can see, are we getting any list of array? It's just simply zero. Number of, we didn't find any tag name AR over here. So it just returned zero. So that's what it said, that it won't give any error or something. It will just return an empty list. It will just return, like, if the element is not found, it will return an empty list. Over here, it returned zero. So there's no tag name AR. So this is what is the difference between find element and find elements. This is one of the interview question which is asked in Selenium, and it is also one of the most important questions that is asked. So this is all for today. In the next tutorial, we will learn what is XPath, and we will practically implement that. We will also download the CrowPath plugin that we used for XPath. So till then, thank you, goodbye, and please like, share, and subscribe this video.